Hello friends, today we will look into the concept of seed formation in a plant and also learn about male and female reproductive organs of a plant, then pollination and fertilization process similar to that of humans and animals, and in the end about artificial pollination. Stay tuned. Plants reproduce using eggs, also known as ova, and sperms, just like humans and animals. Male plants release pollen grains, which fertilize the ovaries. The fertilized ovaries develop into seeds, which are like zygote and embryo, which are either dispersed naturally, either by wind or by animals, or if planted into soil by humans, grow into new plants. So keeping this concept in mind, For the formation of seeds or to collect your own seeds for your garden and also for plant propagation, you must also know a few more concepts and terms of botany in gardening. First thing is the flower. Flower is the reproductive unit of many plants. To understand the reproductive organs of a plant, the parts of the flower should be known, which include petals, sepals, the carpels and the stamens. The external parts of the flower are the petals and the sepals. Plants or flowers can be unisexual or bisexual, also known as hermaphrodite, similar to that of genders in humans. Bisexual, also known as the perfect flowers, meaning their flowers have both male and female parts in the same flower. And unisexual, also known as imperfect flowers, meaning they have only one organs, that is either female or either male. Most flowers are bisexual, and we shall study the anatomy of a flower and different parts of a flower in this illustrated diagram. What parts are the male reproductive organs? The stamens are male reproductive parts of the flower. A stamen consists of an anther, also known as pollen boxes, which produces pollen grains. And the second part of this is the filament. The pollen consists of the male reproductive cells, and these fertilize the ovules or the female reproductive cells or eggs. Now, what parts are the female reproductive organs? The pistil is a collective term for the carpel. So each carpel or the female part includes a stigma, which receives pollen grains during fertilization, and a style, a tube on the top of the ovary, and an ovary where the ovules or the egg cells of the female reproductive cells or the eggs are produced. So that was the illustration of the female reproductive parts of a flower. Now coming to what is pollination and what is fertilization. Pollination is the process by which pollen grains are transferred to the female reproductive organs of a plant, thereby enabling fertilization to take place. This can be compared to copulation in animals, and fertilization is the same term used for the formation of zygote in animals and humans. Pollination can either be natural or artificially done by humans. In case of bisexual or the perfect flowers, pollination happens within the same plant, and then the seeds are formed, and this is called self-pollination. If this happens from one plant to a different plant, it is called cross-pollination. Well, we'll not go into the depths of these. The points you must note is you must not prevent or drive away or even kill the natural pollinators or insects like honeybees and butterflies, which are useful agents in gardening and plant reproduction. These insects are called pollen vectors. These insects like honeybees and butterflies fly from flower to flower collecting sweet nectar. As they visit the flowers, they spread pollens around and deposit it on some stigmas. After a male's pollen grains have landed on the stigma during the fertilization process, pollen tubes develop within the style, burrowing down to the ovary where the sperm fertilizes an ovum, or this the egg cell, in the ovule. After fertilization, the ovule develops into a seed in the ovary. Then also regarding artificial pollination, which is an interesting topic in gardening. Here we humans intervene with the natural pollination process. We take out the pollen grains or the plant sperms from one flower and transfer it to another, allowing the pollen to fertilize the ovaries and then create seeds that will help develop into fruits, and then we get new plants. We shall not go into details of this at present, and our main purpose of the video is especially for newbie gardeners to clear the concept of how plants reproduce and how seeds are formed in plants. And this is called sexual method of propagation. And asexual propagation is another topic. Most of us grow plants from cuttings, and this is the best example of asexual propagation. Well folks, that's all in today's video. Please give a thumbs up if you like the video, and also consider subscribing to the channel if you're new to the channel. Happy gardening!